I hate the Call of Duty community. I don't hate the game. I love the game, in fact. You know, Modern Warfare 3, Black Ops 1, they're all beautiful games. I hate the community, right? The majority of the community. And this is why. Oh, you probably have no idea what's going on. All right, let me clear some things up for you. The like and dislike bar on the left belongs to the Call of Duty Infinite Warfare trailer. And the like and dislike bar on the right belongs to the Call of Duty World War II trailer. You understand now? No? Okay. All right. I have three pet peeves in this world. Counting down, number three is people touching me while I stretch. Don't touch me when I stretch. Number two is people smoking around children. And number one is ungrateful people. Yeah. Ungrateful people. I can't stand them. Women in Thailand think they have it hard with all the prostitution and sex slavery. I would suck a dick, my dude. I would, no, 12 dicks to be exact, before I have to put up with an ungrateful bastard. I would have killed that Oliver Twist kid. You know what Oliver Twist is, right? That kid that he like, can I get some more, please? Ungrateful, I would have killed that kid. And that's exactly what the COD community is. A bunch of Oliver Twists. Hey there, buddy. You can't go around calling us ungrateful without proof. Okay. In 2003, Call of Duty, or COD 1, was sold to the public. Themed a war game, it exhibited the general elements of how fighting, guns, and general war equipment were during World War II, with a bit of warped reality. It was an instant success with the public cashing in at around 70 million. Looking at this game right now, you might say, hey, that game looks like shit, complete garbage. I'd hang my wife just to get this trash off the screen. The animations are choppy, the guns look like toys, and the graphics in general looks like everything's made out of brown bubblegum. Well, you'd be right, but you have to understand, this was 2003. At the time, male and female gamers were still masturbating to titles like Doom and Wolfenstein. And ever since Halo 1 came out 2 years before, it left the masses hungry for any type of decent FPS game that was thrown at them, especially one with a different time genre. And you can say anything about the game that you want, but you could tell just by playing it. The game wasn't made for the sole purpose of making money. It was to create something new. Something fresh, something no one's ever seen before, to invent and innovate the path for FPS games on the rise. Then, in 2005, Activision said, wow, this piece of shit game actually made some money? Let's make the same exact thing. And that's when Call of Duty 1, Call of Duty 2 was released to the public. Being themed a war game, it exhibited general elements of how fighting, guns, and general war equipment were during World War II with a bit of warped reality. Then, in 2006, Call of Duty turned around, made a completely new game, new theme, new guns, new everything. I forgot what it was about though. Oh yeah, a World War II game that exhibits fighting, guns, and general war equipment with a bit of- After COD received criticism from both critics and players in the community about the repetitiveness in theme, story, and gameplay, they sought out to make a newer game. One with more dignity, one with more respect, passion, Modern Warfare. Alright, with this game, COD put their foot down and they said no more unnecessary titles, no more gameplay predictability, and one thing's for certain, no more milking a title for money. To keep this video short and give you the point straight, I'm gonna have to skip over Black Ops 1, 2, 3, Advanced Warfare, Ghost, blah blah blah. Alright, the day is May 2nd, the year is 2016, and Call of Duty releases the sexiest thing, in my opinion, the world has ever seen. A COD game that displays a completely different everything. A game that actually stood alone by itself, completely different setting, got dudes in spacesuits and spaceships in outer space, shit blowing up in the back, they got ground control to Major Tom as the trailer music, mechs like it's Titanfall or something. Finally, we've got what we wanted, right? A new game, an original, except we don't like it. Why? Why is there so much hate before the game is even dropped? Don't worry, I'll answer that myself. Well, that's because we're ungrateful little shits that complain about how stale an overused aspect of a game is. We're ungrateful little shits that elaborate about how predictable the tactics of a game are. And once we get what we want, we throw a tantrum. You want to touch the stove, but when your mom says no, you cry. Then you touch it anyways, and you find out why she didn't want you to touch it in the first place. You little bitch. The funny part of it all is Activision, the ones in charge of making Infinite Warfare, already knew you ungrateful bastards were gonna hate the game anyways. They already knew. That's why they added Modern Warfare Remastered to bait you sad sacks of shits into buying it regardless. Hey, these kids keep asking us to change up the genre a little. What should we do? Well, they're gonna hate it anyways. Let's just get that straight. But to give them what they want and make at least a little bit of money, throw in a remastered edition of an old game they used to like or something. I don't know. It's like, hey, can we get a new game? Except, can it be the same exact game? So now, I don't expect COD to produce or make any type of titles that are even slightly different from the setting that they've reused and recycled. You can throw that idea into the trash. All you had to do was give the game a chance. Just one chance, you know? At least start disliking it after you've received the game. Now, we're stuck with this for the rest of our lives. Over 3.5 million dislikes to something that you wanted, but over 1 million likes for a theme that was the problem in the first place. All I can say is have fun with your Call of Duty World War II once it comes out November 3rd. Have fun with your war game that exhibits the general elements of how fighting, guns, and general war equipment were during World War II. Enjoy. When the stars make- This video is sponsored by Kneecaps. Go like and subscribe. By the way, that's me. Like and subscribe to me. When you dance down the street with the club at your feet, you're in.